150 million kilometers from Earth, there is a clean and inexhaustible power source which could supply us with much more energy than we would ever use. How did we learn to exploit it? Humans have been harnessing the sun's power since the beginning of time. In the 5th century BC, the Greeks were already designing their buildings to make the most of the sunlight, and the Romans incorporated glass into windows to keep heat inside their homes. However, it was not until 1839 that French physicist Edmond Becquerel, while studying Faraday, observed that exposing metal electrodes to light produced small electrical currents. Almost 45 years later, on the roof of an apartment in New York, the American inventor Charles Fritts spread a layer of selenium on a metal plate and covered it with a thin film of gold leaf. When light hit the device, part of that light was absorbed by the selenium and excited its electrons. This way, the released electrons flowed through the gold layer, generating an electric current. Fritts had created the first solar cell, although, unfortunately, it barely reached 1% efficiency. At that time, no one understood why this was happening, and the scientific community received these advances coldly. The explanation for this phenomenon came in the first decade of the 20th century, when a young Albert Einstein suggested that light was composed of photons and demonstrated the photoelectric effect. The next great advance came from Russell Shoemaker Ohl, almost by accident, while he was studying the semiconductor properties of some silicon samples. Ohl discovered that, by adding certain impurities to this material, a strong electric current was generated. On April 24, 1954, Bell Laboratories announced the construction of the first practical solar panel, using it to power a toy Ferris wheel and a radio transmitter. Today, solar cells are used in all types of devices. Advanced designs and materials have made it possible to build solar cells that reach more than 30% efficiency, and research and development continues so that, one day, we will be able to achieve one of humanity's most desired aspirations, the use of the almost unlimited energy from the sun for the benefit of our society.